Hey, this is Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. Thank you for tuning in today. Today's YouTube video, we're going to show you how our new restate works and how reconditioning a battery and show you how that comes together. Before you get excited in the comments about Where's Jeff, he is currently starring in a local production of Les Mis in Reykjavik, so he's still enjoying retirement. Also, if you'd like, we've got a link to his woodworking channel here in our comments below. Check him out there. Go ahead and subscribe. You'll have a great time looking at some of the really cool stuff he's producing. But today, let's move over to the workbench and we'll show you how the restate works in reconditioning a battery. I got my tools laid out here. Basically, what I've done is I bummed a battery from our neighbor. Shout out to Ducey over here. I asked him to give me like the worst battery you've got around, and he's like, okay, here you go. So we got this battery. I've just got my Klein multimeter up here and we've got our restate and got a battery charger. So what I want to do is just show you real quick, and I may have to move things around a little bit. Can you see that okay? Okay, so I'm going to show you on this battery that it's pulling 12 and a half. It was, when we were testing, it was pulling about 12.4 when we were getting ready for this. So we've brought it up a little scope. So there it is, 12. So 12 and a half. And we know this is a bad battery because Mark was going to send it back, so it's got some real problems. What we want to do is we want to desulfate, we want to use our restate and basically bring this battery back to life. So you can see it's a crusty old bear. It's been out somewhere in a rough environment. Now, so what we've got with our restate, this is our 12-volt restate. You'll see when you open the box up, you've got your instructions and all that. One of the things that's slightly different, the instructions say that it needs to be about 12.9. So it has to have some voltage in there before it can really start to do the pulsing and the desulfating. So what we're going to do is, first off, we're going to go ahead and connect this up for a couple of nights and let this charge and show that you know, putting on the charger doesn't help in the battery state that it's in. So I'm gonna leave this plugged up for a couple of days and we're gonna come back and we'll see what voltage it's showing there. And because this is a really crusty battery, like I said, it's gonna stay, it may come up a little bit, 12.5 like it's doing, maybe 12.6, something like that. But it's not gonna be enough that you could reuse this battery. And then what we'll do is we'll stick the restate on there and let it sit for probably about a week. And we'll add some power to it up here also so that we have that operating range. I was saying that the operating range and the instructions say, I think it's 12.9 is what the operating, I think that's a little conservative. I think it'll start pulsing around 12.7. So what we've got to do is we've got to, in this case, with this battery being as low it is, we've got to artificially bring that up. And so if you had a solar panel hooked up to it or anything like this case, since we're inside here in the shop, we're gonna throw it just on a charger. And that charger will bring it up past that 12.7, 12.9 so that the pulsing will start to happen. So I'm gonna leave this hooked up for now and we'll come back in a couple of days, do the second part of this video and show what that battery looks like after a couple of days. Okay, so we've had this set up for about 2 days on trickle charge. And we'll pull it off and let's take a look and see what my voltage looks like. So 12.8 came up a little bit, but not anything near what we would expect or what we'd need it to. So what we're gonna do now, pull those off and let me hook up our restate. So what I've got is got my restate out of the box. And what I wanna do is I'm gonna connect up I'm gonna go ahead and use the external power. 12.8 would probably start the restate running, but I wanna be sure, and so I'm gonna make sure by adding some juice to it. So I've got my handy dandy green LED light running right there. Lets me know everything is rolling. And so what we'll do is we'll leave this on for about a week. And that'll just make sure, and what's happening is that sending pulses through that battery, knocking that sulfation off the plates. And so we'll leave that there. let that work its magic, and then we'll come back, like I said, in about a week, and we'll check the battery again, see if it's a good battery or not. Our SkyMax Restate with the magic green eye here has been running for about a week now. And so it's time to pull off the charge, pull off the restate. Let's take a look and see what the battery looks like. So we'll just disconnect everything here. Set this aside. Got my trusty Klein multimeter. Let's see. So there we go. It's knocking up around 13.3, somewhere like that. That's pretty steady right there. That's a good battery. We took a really crusty battery here. Couldn't hold the charge. Set it up on the restate for about a week. And now we've got, really would be a battery we just go take back over to Ducey and tell them to stick it in a car or a tractor, wherever it came off from. That's the power of the SkyMax Restate. It's a very inexpensive way to basically bring a battery back up to state. Thanks for checking out this video. Subscribe to our videos to see anything coming up. Hit the bell, and we'll keep bringing you videos. Thanks a lot.